Shit. We are getting slaughtered.
How many bullets do you have left?
These?
Red bullets don't fit in our guns. No. We have two blue bullets left.
Are you kidding me?
That's it. Here, take one. I'll take one.
Less is
Here we go.
All right, and three.
It's been an honor.
You've been annoying the entire time.
Two.
One. Let's go.
Bitches.
This is John Patrick Lowry, voice of the sniper, and you're watching The Rack Show on VoxVii.com. Join Conrad and Lucas as they take geek culture off the shelf. I'll show you how to take geek culture right now and show it to you. You want to show it to me? I'll show it to you. The Rack Show, geek culture at its best. Boom. Headshot.
Yes?
Hey.
Conrad Lucas.
Nice to meet you, Lucas.
Conrad, nice to meet you.
So,
welcome to the Dark Club.
We're going
to
play darts today.
Yes. Not your normal darts.
I'm going to shoot too much. Let's check this out. We're hanging out here at the Blue Base at the Detroit Dart Club, and you have an array of weaponry. Tell us a little bit more about this stuff.
Yes, so I'll go over the different guns we have, blasters, as they're called in the Nerf community.
Nice.
So we have all the mega blasters here neatly set up. As you see, neatly set up. This will get destroyed in about 2 minutes. All the mega blasters here are the red ones. These shoot the big red darts here. They pack a pretty big punch.
Okay.
They're all pretty easy. All the guns are all front loading, so you just like load in the side right here. You can rotate it over, pull back, fire like that. And what's fun about the red guns, or the mega darts, is they get a nice whistle to them. So when you're in the battle, you just hear darts whistling by your head.
Okay.
These guys are my personal favorite. These are the Mega Magnuses. If you don't mind, I'll take that out of your hands for a second. So I can't pull back. That means it's already ready to fire. What's fun about these is they're pretty accurate. As you see, shooting at a target.
Uh-huh.
I'll go over gameplays too, but we have targets, yes. We have the rough cuts here, also known as the shotguns. These are nice because they shoot two darts at once. We give a little pump, fire like that.
Like a shotgun, and these use different darts.
Yes, so all the elite and zombie strike blasters here, as they're called, shoot all the elite darts, the blue darts they are. So red guns, red darts, all the other guns, blue darts. What I like about these guys is these are the only guns that you can dual wield with.
Okay.
Oh yeah, you can pull back with one hand. That's how it's easy to dual wield. The other guns, you need two hands to do a pump action. But these are pretty accurate. They're fun just going down the line and pop, pop, pop. But
I was doing that earlier. It was fun.
But yeah, so we have about 20 blasters in each base. And all the guns on the blue side have blue tape on them. All the guns on the red side have red tape on them, so they stay on their sides. Exact same setup, but normally there's a lot more guns than people. So what you want to do is guns and ammo you are not using is scatter them at different sections so you don't have to come back to the base to reload and all that.
Okay.
So now I'll go into some of the gameplay.
How big is this room first?
So this room is 2,000 square feet.
Okay,
so
cool.
It's close quarters, but it's when you get going, it's obvious that it's a good size for Nerf battles.
Yeah.
So once you get to a certain distance, Nerf... the darts just don't get that accurate.
Yeah.
But also, you'll see with the gameplay that's custom for this place, your games usually go about 2 or 3 minutes, and anything more than that, that's like a workout. You don't realize it, but when you're doing this the whole time,
yeah.
And like
a lot of
sliding and running around and stuff, mm-hmm. And when it's over, you're like, oh man.
It's different in first-person shooters where you just hit X and you go down. And...
exactly. I like to think of this as like...
how's that go again?
Exactly.
That actually hurt. Okay. It's going to be a fun day.
Yeah. Also, I always forget to tell people they should probably stretch before, but I always forget. So there we go.
And then you have long bombers too, right? These
yes. So we have some things that you can throw, grenades you can call them. These are from the Nerf demolishers. I don't have the demolishers here because they use the magazines, and those tend to jam a lot.
Okay.
Also, with the automatics, they break easily, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you can throw these at people. We got these little missiles here. I got a target. Wildly inaccurate, but pretty hilarious to use. So sometimes they go right to the floor like that. Sometimes they go in the air and they're whipping by your head. But yeah, those are a lot of fun. But yeah, so
what are the games?
Different blasters. So, all right, so we have three different gameplays. Well, four, kind of. We just started doing another one.
Okay.
So in the beginning, I get people in. We'll do a practice round, usually around 5 minutes. For that, it's very simple. If you get shot, you just run back in your base to respawn.
In your base to respawn, yeah.
Yep. Okay. You basically just run in and run out. Gives you a chance to try out the different blasters, figure out which ones you like, which ones you don't like. And then after that, once people are all well worked up, we'll get into the gameplay.
Okay.
So we start off with a very simple gameplay called Team Elimination. This game is just shooting people. It's one shot and you're out. For 2 minutes, you cannot cross the orange center line we have out here. Just divide the place in half. I'll be doing a countdown. I'll yell out there's 1 minute remaining, 30 seconds, 15, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and I'll blow the whistle. When you hear the whistle blown, you can cross the center line and it's last team standing. So if you get shot, you just step off the arena and wait for the next game. Those games don't go very long, usually around 2.5 minutes, basically.
Wow, these games are really fast.
It doesn't feel like it.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see that in the practice round, and I'll probably do like a 4 minute practice round. When it's over, I'll say, by the way, that was 4 minutes, to give you an idea of what that feels like.
We'll be
and
dying.
It's going to feel like, it's going to feel more like 10 minutes. Games sometimes last like 30 seconds for the next gameplay I'll be explaining. Mm-hmm. But each game we do about like 3 or 4 times, and then we'll move on to the next gameplay. Maybe do a break at some point for like water and whatnot. But yeah, we'll do the elimination a few times to get everyone, again, the feel for the place. And then we'll move into Team Slayer, which is my personal favorite. And with like our age group, it's kind of the club favorite. For that,
adult 12-year-olds is what it is.
Adult 12-year-olds.
Lost boys.
Yes. We get a lot of 10, 11, 12-year-old parties, and then a lot of 30-year-old parties in here. That's right. A lot of team outings, too. I would say like we mostly get adults in here. Although it's kind of different. Some weekends, it's like all kids, and some weekends, it's like all adults. It's just totally random. But for Team Slayer, your goal is to shoot down the targets on the opponent's side. They're the orange cones that are set up. You saw me shoot one of those down earlier.
Okay.
Your goal is to shoot the 4 targets on the opponent's side. You cannot cross the center line in this game. If you get shot, you just run back to your base to respawn and get back to the action. So you're not out in this game. The team that shoots down the opponent's targets first is the winner. I keep track of time. We have the record on the board. Top 3 times are on the website. The record right now is 10 seconds, which is pretty fast.
And now what is the website?
The website, DetroitDartClub.com.
Awesome.
Yep, and you can go to records. And we have top 3 times with their team pictures. But yeah, most games, to give you an idea, though, go about 2 to 3 minutes. First game is always the longest because people are figuring out strategy as they go on.
Uh-huh.
But usually if it gets to that minute and a half range, usually that's an indicator that like people are getting the hang of it and they're having a good time. Strategy for that, I recommend definitely scattering guns and ammo you aren't using at different sections. Mm-hmm. That game, you want to be aggressive. You don't want to be in your base. You don't want to be hanging back. Because like I said, Nerf guns shooting at a target this big, it's difficult the further away you are.
Yeah.
And there's certain guns that are better at shooting targets. The rough cut shotguns are. All the Mega Blasters, basically. I didn't show you this guy. We got Thunderbow here.
Thunderbow.
Again, front loading. Every once in a while, a dart might come out like that, and it won't fire, so you just pop it back in. Pull back like this. See? Pretty violently.
Katniss Everdeen.
Accurate. Not accurate, but she's pretty violent.
Or Katniss, Hawkeye. Or
all that.
Green Arrow. Or Robin Hood.
People with bows, right?
Bows.
Yeah. That's what you're trying to say. It's people with bows. I thought I'd chime in now.
And then, so that's Team Slayer.
I may or may not just shot our cameraman directly in the face.
And bucket
completely
went
on
down.
Accident.
Did you not know it was loaded?
I did. I put the dart.
At least he has glasses on.
Yeah.
One of our very few safety rules is you have to wear glasses. And good for you.
Mike, are you okay?
Chin sore.
Your chin sore? All right. Sorry, Bucket. My bad. Yeah.
That just shows, again, these are close quarters here. So when it's a face shot, it can be pretty startling. It doesn't hurt really, but it'll wake you up. That's Team Slayer.
What's
and then
the third
we'll,
one?
The third one's Humans vs. Zombies. We should do that towards
what?
The end. Yes.
Will's got to be a zombie, calling it.
Yeah, like you said. Usually everyone's like, all right, so we have usually 1 or 2 zombies on the red side. That's the zombie side. Everyone else will be on the human side. We've had some really big groups here where we've had like maybe 2 zombies against like 25, 30 humans.
Oh my gosh, these are big groups.
Yes, very big groups. So for that, there are 2 ways for humans to win. I'll explain humans first. Either you can win by shooting down the 4 targets on the zombie side. That's one way. Or eliminate zombies by shooting them in the head.
Headshots.
Right? Headshots only.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
So wait a second. The humans can win just by shooting those targets?
Yeah, but you'd be surprised. Zombies win about 9 out of 10
How do
times.
The zombies win?
Yeah.
Zombies win one way. That's to make everyone into zombies.
That's a long
By move. Shooting them, I'm guessing,
yep.
anywhere?
So if you're shot by a zombie, you join the zombie side.
So if I was a zombie and I just shot Bucket, he would be a zombie now.
Join the zombie
the
side.
Side.
Yep.
Okay.
But here's the other catch. As a zombie, if you get shot anywhere but the head, nothing happens to you. You don't have to respawn or anything. And as zombies, these are 28 weeks later zombies. You're going to be running around. These are aggressive zombies.
Those are super rage people because they weren't... Okay, we're not going to get into 28 days later zombies because that, in my personal opinion, they're not zombies.
Zombies. Well, they never say zombies in zombie
they
movies
don't.
Anyways.
They don't say that in Walking Dead either.
Well,
I know.
Walking Dead, they very much are zombies. In the
in 28 days later, they don't.
They never
like,
say it.
I'm like, how about a show that's like, hey, these are zombies.
If zombies were zombies, then they'd be like, hey, guess what? Shoot them in the head. We're done. Time to quell the zombie apocalypse. So there's no evidence of zombies anywhere in the Walking Dead mythos. But in 28 Days Later, they never mention it because they're not. They're infected. They basically have super
infected
rabies.
Infected with rage.
Yes,
right?
Rage.
Yeah.
I gotta go watch that movie.
28 Days Later?
I've seen the first one, which is 28,
28
right?
Days Later, yeah.
And there's
28 Weeks Later. When they try to get civilization and they kind of fail. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Love it.
I'm ready to shoot people.
Yeah, let's do this.
Oh, I guess I should explain one more thing.
Oh, please.
If there's time, sometimes we'll do a one-on-one tournament. We're still working on the name. I want to call it Thunderdome, but there's also a Nerf movement that's going around that this guy is doing an awesome thing in his backyard, and like it's kind of spreading. And he calls it Thunderdome. And when I saw that, I was like, oh. But because I like the idea, you know, two men enter, one man leaves.
Or woman.
Or woman. But the quote is, two men enter, one man leaves in Thunderdome.
I'm trying to be all-encompassing.
I know.
So now how does that work?
So that works. One-on-one. We got a person behind the blue pole, person behind the red pole. Everyone else is around the perimeter, watching, cheering, reffing. You get one gun, fully loaded. One shot, you're out. No center line. Everyone goes 3, 2, 1, go, and then they go at it.
I want to play that one. I want to play all your versions.
So that's that's like, you know, bracket setup, one game elimination, one champion.
Nice.
Yeah, so that's a lot of fun.
So we're going to do this?
We have to do that.
We're
going to
do
all of it. Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
We're going to do this now.
One, two, three, shoot.
Okay, go.
Did I go first? I thought we were just practicing.
Were you recording?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so... I want to win, but I want to pick you. I'm going to take Rachel.
Wow, really?
Oh, that was a bad choice.
All right, then I'm going to pick Corey. Yeah. We got to split up.
We're splitting them up.
Yeah,
that's all
that comes. It feels so good.
We split the interns, too, so yeah. I will take... This one that says B.
That's Brendan.
Brendan. I will take Brendan.
I'll take Brandon because I actually know his name, but stand there because we need you to be mine.
Okay, I will
no,
take... I gotta stick with fam, I'm gonna take Will.
Alright, then I will pick Jomar.
Love so you. We have one extra guy. What do we do with the extra guy?
We should have 10.
Cut him in. Got Amy. A little off. It happens.
Really? We have 10?
Oh, Amy.
Amy's not playing the first
one.
So you can go on his team. Because we're going to win anyways because they got
Why is he last pick, though?
That?
Like, that's
What?
Nobody likes being last pick.
But
it was late today. That's why he was
last pick. That's right. He was here like an hour ago. So we're face off.
Yep.
Okay. We call blue, or do you want. You get to. Since you said sorry, you want.
Pick red.
Pick what?
Red.
Pick red.
We're picking blue.
We're picking blue. Okay, let's do
Your it. Your team right. wanted red. You the captain.
Yeah. All right, guys. We're going to start off with team elimination. That's the game where it's one shot, you're out. For 2 minutes, you cannot cross this orange center line here. I'll be doing a countdown. I'll be on 1 minute remaining, 30 seconds, 15, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and I'll blow the whistle. When you hear the whistle blown, you can cross the line and it's last team standing. So if you get shot, you can step out of the arena and wait for the next game. My suggestion is make sure you're not in the base when that 2 minutes is up because the other team will just swarm it. Also, make sure you're fully loaded when that 2 minutes is coming up. That's about all the strategy I can give. Every game starts inside the base. I'll go red team ready, blue team ready, 3, 2, 1, go. All right? So I'll give me another couple seconds to load up.
Right. Damn.
Red team won!
Oh my god.
No,
thanks to you. You were the first out, dude. You got shot.
I'm the biggest target.
Well, yeah.
Whose fault is that?
I was fine with my boss.
I suggest getting really aggressive in this game. Put guns and ammo up at the tires. You guys want to get right up to the line. The more aggressive team is the one that wins. Red team, right?
Yeah.
Blue team, right?
Got me. He was almost out of ammo, too.
I had two shots.
I had two, single shot.
That's what you know, it is.
Oh my god, you can't actually lift me.
I got this. He's not even showing up. He's not even here. I got this.
Did you make sure that you did the dishes tonight? Baby, it was your turn to do the dishes.
Yeah, it's your turn to do the dishes. I did them last week, Rachel.
Are you freaking kidding me?
No!
Are you serious?
No!
Oh!
She got me right in the heart.
Right
in the side, but really in the heart.
Season 3, Episode 13 of The Rack Show, which you can listen to on VoxVii's YouTube channel, VoxVii.com, and TheRackShow.com. I'm Conrad.
I'm Lucas.
Yeah, and as you can tell, we aren't where sometimes we usually are.
We're sweating.
We are, and for good reason. And for nothing that's inappropriate, I promise.
No, we have been playing Dart Wars. Is that what we call this?
Yes.
Is it what we call this?
Dart Wars, Nerf Wars.
Nerf Wars, Dart Wars.
Urban Warfare, whatever.
With big darts and little darts.
Little darts and phallic darts.
Yeah, it's been pretty great.
We've
been here with the crew all day.
Yep.
It's a on-location shoot, so we're inside of the Russel Industrial Center.
In the Detroit Dart League.
Yes.
Dart Club. Sorry.
We're exhausted from playing.
As you can tell, my brain barely works right now.
Yeah, we're here at the Russel Industrial Center, right off 75 and Grand Avenue. Is that what this is, or Clay?
Clay.
So Grand, Clay and...
You notice the big mural of the Cyber Sphinx outside. He's literally got his door
directly
beneath
that. It's not a Sphinx.
What is it?
It's a Detroit Chimera.
It's a Detroit Chimera. Essentially, it has the red wings, it has the pistons on the side.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And it has the lion's mane, and it has the tiger stripes.
Anyway, Chimera, and we're underneath that.
Detroit sports, guys.
Yeah, that's a thing. So Connor, we just got done playing four different versions of the Detroit Dart Club stuff. Can you rehash those real fast for us?
Yep. So we got Team Elimination. It's a good game to start off with. Simple. It's one shot, you're out.
Mm-hmm. Again. Lucas won all of those with
his
team.
That's right.
Yeah, I won. So go and check that out. Did I win?
Yes. You won. Yeah.
I won.
So for that game, simple. One shot, you're out. For 2 minutes, you can't cross this orange center line here. I do a countdown. I yell out 1 minute remaining, 30 seconds, 15, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And I'll blow the whistle. When you hear the whistle blown, you can cross the line. Last team standing.
Guns a-blazing.
Guns a-blazing.
Or as whatever Nerf boost. Never really blaze, but yeah.
Very cool. And then, yeah, so we went from there to Team Slayer, which is usually a favorite.
And this is one of my favorites, definitely. Yeah. I mean, so, we won them all, but it was one of my favorites.
It is fun to win. You know, sometimes we get groups that I'm like, you want to switch up teams a little bit? And they're like, no. And I'm like, all right.
I personally think we should have, but we didn't. Just saying.
I mean, when you have a winning team, why would you want to change it?
Right? Fairness.
I mean,
fun. It's more fun for everyone. Yeah. When it's the variety is the spice of life, Lucas, that's why we're here at the Detroit Dark Club.
Yeah, well,
right? We're not doing it from your living room like season one.
We did, we won.
And then the next one?
The next one we did was, what is that? Humans vs. Zombies. Yeah.
Yes, Humans vs. Zombies. That's a fun one.
That was fun. We didn't do it with your group. I forgot. We sometimes turn the lights off on the zombie side. I'm sorry. Oh, you had to set the mood and everything.
Yeah. Our interns were the zombies.
And I didn't think they would win.
And they
zombies
did.
Usually win, though.
I realize it's a lot harder than it looks.
Well, you have a target of an entire body as opposed to a target of a head.
Yes, but what people forget a lot is you can also win by shooting targets.
Which we did not do.
Yeah. Which, I mean, understandable. Why would you want to shoot targets when you have the option
to shoot? I wanted to shoot at the interns Brennan and Brennan, right, obviously.
Who are on camera today, so if any of the camera shots look crazy, that's their fault.
And if they look really good, the rack show people who are looking after them is going to get the credit.
They're camera mentors.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's their first time on camera.
and then we did a Thunderdome.
That was fun.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Yeah. I like it a lot. Again, the name. I love the name Thunderdome, but I feel like I need to change it just because that gentleman, I forget where he started his club in his backyard, but I feel like he has exclusive rights to the name Thunderdome, I gotta think of something different.
Where you go in with one gun on either side and shoot at each other until someone's hit, and then you go forward in the tournament. Jomar, actually, surprisingly, in my opinion, was a dark horse and won the whole shebang. And then I had the great idea of being like, oh, it's you versus Connor.
Be glad you.
Because I wanted to put him up as a sacrificial lamb. And I guess apparently the meek will inherit the earth because Jomar won that one as well.
Yeah.
Even by switching up a gun in the end. He was using the shotgun. Jomar, your zipper's down. So even though Jomar won...
He's over here prancing.
The Thunderdome. He's dancing at us. He's trying to be all, ooh, I won. And then we realize that, you know...
His zipper's down.
He's still Jomar. So, which we say out
of. No, this has been a lot of fun. Did you guys have fun?
Yeah.
It's also producer Corey's wife's birthday, so this is probably... Was this a cool birthday for you?
Yeah.
Yeah, she loved it.
She said yes. I don't know if you can pick that up.
She was running, like, full tilt.
She was good.
Gunning people.
Yeah, she got the
first. She was my first pick. She was the first because we picked teams.
Yep.
And I got first pick, and I picked Rachel.
And
we
picked
agreed
we were
that we would
split
the Milton's. And we would split up the interns.
Boy, how do you
I think
really
she was
well.
The most aggressive
yeah,
of everyone. And that's how you want to play here, is you want to be aggressive.
First time out, she won the first game for us.
And that was after you were at a little bit of a detriment. It was like 2 versus 3, and then just...
Yeah, it was 4 versus 5.
Yeah.
Until we got Amy, because she was filming it. So you're probably seeing this right now. The footage we're talking about.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah, and the end of it ended up being 2 versus 3, and then I got out, and then it was 2 versus 2, and Bucket and intern Brandon just decided to be really scared little bunnies and not move around. I'm not bitter at all for losing, but they didn't move at all. They just sat there.
Who did?
They just let people run up on them and shoot them. They heard the whistle, and they were just like, we're going to take a leisurely nap. And Bucket was the big spoon, and just
Bucket
bigger,
was the big
you know.
Spoon.
I'm yelling at them to go, and they're not listening to me because I'm dead. So,
Conrad, you need to get your team together, man.
Yeah.
My team listened. What?
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that we won?
Yeah. I still won No Death Mario, though.
Yeah. Well, that's true. We'll have to talk about that at the end here. Summer of Challange. This is the month we started.
Now, you started off, you just liked Nerf, but you had different jobs before this. Tell us, like, what you were directly before this.
Yeah. Directly before this, I was working retail full-time. Mm-hmm. I look back and I think, you know, all the jobs I had, I'm like, you know, I kind of kind of glad they were jobs that weren't really for me.
Like, yeah.
It was kind of a motivation to go out and try my own thing. But I was like, I don't know what to do, though. But all I know is the next thing I am doing has to be something I enjoy.
Okay. But when I think of businesses, mm-hmm. my mind doesn't automatically go to Nerf guns.
Right, yeah.
How did you make that jump?
So about a year and a half, no, 2 years ago, I'd say, is when I started doing Nerf Wars in my house.
In your house?
In my house. Small house, too. 900 square feet. And it evolved into a game we called Nerf Slayer. And it turned into a weekly thing where more people came. And it just like kind of evolved from there. I'll tell you the rules for that. Gameplay is basically what inspired me to do this. Because like...
What did you break? That's what I want to know.
Break like everything out out of the way. Anything that was fragile. I don't
know.
Just
bought replacements made out of Nerf everything.
Yeah.
It's Nerf cheap.
And I was willing to risk, you know, just damaging whatever because, you know, it's fun.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
So what we did was we had, there's the main floor and we had an upstairs and a basement. There's an offensive team and a defensive team. The offensive team starts the top floor. Defensive team starts in the basement. We go 3-2-1. They meet in the middle. Both teams can't cross the line between kitchen and living room. We also have all furniture toppled over and blankets and stuff like that. But yeah, so there's the offense's team goal is to shoot down all the cans that were set up in the kitchen, and there was one that was really far away, all within 4 minutes that was set on the microwave. Yeah, and the defensive team, their goal was to stop them from getting all the targets down. And so, again, like similar to Team Slayer here, if you get shot on the offensive team, you have to run up the stairs, touch the window, run down the stairs.
That was their base.
That was, yeah.
Okay.
And then defensive team, you get shot, you run down the basement and touch the washer or dryer, run up the stairs. These are, as you can tell, it's a workout running on flat ground.
Yeah.
Add stairs to it. Oh my gosh. Your legs are burning. This is strictly a winter sport because in the summer, it's like there's nowhere to go. It's like, because the house gets really hot.
Wow.
But I think the record was like 8 seconds or something like that. And there's a lot of targets. It's a lot. You're just like going through. And that was when we used guns with magazines, like the Rampage. Mm-hmm. And that was my personal favorite at the time. And you're just going through. It's like, you know, taking out targets. Yeah. That was the game.
I saw like some of the cans back there.
Yeah. So I just replaced the targets with the cones. I used to have duct tape cans and orange duct tape. Mm-hmm. They're a smaller target, kind of tough to shoot down, but they get mangled pretty easily.
Yeah, I can imagine falling from, like, what, 10 feet up?
Yeah, and not so much when it falls, but, like, getting hit by, like, a mega dart will dent it up. Also, when it falls, people will step on it, and it's just a pain to keep replacing it.
Mega dart.
Yeah.
And so this started off just as fun, just as you hanging
just
out
as
with
fun.
Your friends.
Yeah, I was also in the process of flipping a house, so I knew I had a little bit of money coming my mm-hmm. way. So I was like, all right, so do I, you know, use this money to, you know, buy a cool TV or or something? Or do I, like, you know, follow this idea? And basically, I was like, all right, I want to do this. I'm going to do this. It was a different feeling when I was like, I decided, like, I'm going to do this. I'm not going to be one of those people that's like talk about doing things mm-hmm. and don't do them. But it was pretty like it was going to happen. So I was like, all right, work in retail. Luckily, during the summertime, it's super slow. So all I am doing is taking notes and just figure out how do I want to do this? Like, can I even afford to have a place to rent or mm-hmm. whatever? I was like, do I just go to locations? Someone finally referred me to the Russel Industrial Center. I was like, oh, I didn't know there's stuff going on there. This is probably the fifth space I looked at, and when it opened up to the Chimera Mural, I was like, oh, it's got to be this one.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a slow process. When I decided I wanted to do it, it was probably about 8 months later when I finally did it. And then it took me about a month and a half to get this place looking like it is.
And that was back in August of last year.
Yeah, so I got this space July last year, and then I opened up end of August.
Did you buy all these guns when you started out, or did you add?
No,
did you have a lot
of Nerf guns? Yeah, a lot of trial and error happened.
Did you repair them, or?
You know, some of them I repair, some of them I'm just like, you know, it's just not worth it. Sometimes I'll just, yeah, I don't know.
Now, do you use anything that's not Nerf, or is Nerf like the primary
standard?
Nerf is like the standard, just because the ammo works with it. There's like other companies too, but I think they just like kind of miss the mark a little bit. I just really like Nerf. I like the Megas a lot. I know when I post a picture of groups on Instagram, and that's where a lot of like the Nerf community is.
The Mega.
They'll make a comment saying like, "Oh, all I see is Mega," because mm-hmm. I don't know why. I love Mega, and I think a lot of people like them, but
doesn't seem to be the favorite in the Nerf community.
What do they have rails for?
Oh, you can add attachments.
Like sights.
Like scopes and all that stuff. Yeah.
Bayonet.
Yeah. When we get a lot of kids come in, we let you bring in your own Nerf guns if you want.
Really?
And kids bring in their own custom arsenals, and it's pretty awesome.
I remember in college, you could modify the gun, I think.
For your game, is what you're talking about.
Yes, for our own game, and they would shoot forever.
Yeah.
Like, they were shooting, what, 50 yards sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think they take out the inside? Is that what? I don't know how to do
it. Yeah, you take it out and you replace the spring and a few other things. You can go through the videos. That's another reason why I don't really mod them is because I'm like, that's like way beyond me. I'm sure it's simple, but I'm like, I open it up and I'm like, I don't know how to put this thing back together.
But there's a whole community, is what we're trying to say, is there's a whole community behind here that already exists on the internet.
Yeah, they mod, they paint. You should look up just like the different ones that like paint their Nerf guns, or they even like combine Nerf guns together. Some of my favorites are, they'll have a Nerf gun where they literally like saw off this part and they hook this to the bottom of a gun, so it's like...
Really?
Yeah, so you're out of ammo on that one, you go, you switch to this and you just, you know...
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Stick a gun here, and you're like, say hello to my little friend.
This is my new gun right here.
Pretty much.
This is my new gun.
Yeah, there's a few Nerf guys like on Instagram. Like there's Blastaway. He does really awesome combos. And yeah,
what is this?
This is my, hey, say hello to my little friend.
Is that what you're gonna call it?
Yes.
That's a. Gosh, the movie
Scarface.
I'm so tight. Scarface reference. The new one, not the old one.
Whatever. A one.
No, this is cool. No, we had a lot of fun. When are you open?
So I'm open 7 days a week. This is my full time.
7 days a week.
It's not like I'm here 7 days
or,
a week.
You know, with retail or anything else ever, can you?
No, when I got, I started getting busy in December with team outings for businesses, especially Quicken Loans, mm-hmm. and they were just like booking me out in December for like end of year parties, mm-hmm. and there were points where during the holidays that's like pretty busy for retail, and I felt terrible. I'd like say no to a few groups. I know that's like a big no-no in businesses, like turning away business. So
yeah,
I was like, you know, I'm gonna take
like
a chance and say
have,
I know I'm just like, so I was like, you know, I'm just gonna take a chance. January 1st has to be my last day working retail and just go for it. That's cool. What I did.
So your fourth quarter, which is October to December, is pretty busy with businesses.
Yes. So I would say half the groups we get in here are like team outings for businesses, like a lot of big businesses in Detroit, mm-hmm. Which I was really banking on. I was really hoping for businesses and birthday parties because, you know, even like getting like my friends out to like go out to do stuff, it's like kind of tough to like gather a lot of people. Like even like, because like I'll get a group that's like, oh, you know, we're going to come with our buddies, like, you know, there's going to be 25 of us, and I'm like, oh, is it a birthday or something? And he's like, no, you know, we're just gonna come out. And I'm like, yeah, we'll see. And it's like, oh, we was only like six of us, and I'm like, yeah, I don't know.
No, we have the same issue.
Yeah, so
our first game day, remember doing that last year?
Yeah, it was,
we're like, yeah,
a little
it's
gonna
be
painful.
Huge.
Yeah.
And one guy showed up.
That was your first time meeting producer Corey.
Yeah, producer Corey,
who was like, hey, I got an idea for your t-shirt.
He was the other guy that showed up.
Pretty
he came
much,
up
yeah.
like the last 5 minutes of the show.
Yeah,
we had one guy showed up.
Yeah. I was gonna say, I can't remember.
It's getting people out is hard.
Yeah, that's why I like just like the group bookings, because it's like
yeah,
you know
no,
how many
great.
People are coming, especially the team outings, it's like mandatory kind of. And
yeah.
Birthdays, it's people usually show up for that.
So how can they find out more about your...
So all the info I have is on the website. I think I do a pretty good job of explaining everything, like what to expect when you come, how to get here. You just like basically making sure everyone in the group sees it, because some people are they're under the impression that it's something different, where they're like, oh, an hour and a half session, that doesn't sound like a lot of time, but I'm like,
so
you know, it's playing
for,
a sport
yeah,
for an hour and a half.
We're running out for like 4 or 5 minutes and we're just winded.
Yeah, it's a workout, and it's plenty of time too to take a break and do pizza and cake, and I give myself an hour in between sessions too, so usually it's longer than an hour and a half group, but
awesome.
Yeah. I eat pizza 7 days a week.
Really?
So you're living
every
the dream, basically.
I don't know,
saying.
Man. Every day, it's like, hey, you want some of our pizza? And usually I'm like, sure. Yeah. Or I'm like, not today. And then they leave, and they usually leave like boxes of pizza. And usually I'm actually pretty hungry after that. So right when they leave, I'm like, oh! Just demolish. But yeah, pizza and cake is like
pizza
my strict diet right now. Right when I conquer
like
pizza, people like leave boxes of pizza. I'm like, well, you should see my fridge at home. It's like literally just like Pizza.
You got your dairy, you got your bread, you got your vegetable. Yeah.
All the racks are just gone in there. It's just boxes of pizza.
I wake up, I open the fridge, I'm like, I can't do it. No pizza.
Well, you're doing a cool thing here.
Thank you.
Racketeers out there, you guys got to check this out. What's the website?
Again, please.
It's DetroitDarkClub.com.
There you go. Check out the DetroitDarkClub.com. Get a bunch of your friends together. Book a place here. It's really awesome. When convention comes around, we're gonna try to get you at a convention.
Yeah, we're gonna help.
So we're gonna see if we can maybe get a petition to get him at the next convention, possibly YomaCon. What do you guys
Pretty
think?
Epic.
Right?
YomaCon 2015.
You will make a killing.
It'd just be so much fun.
Yeah,
be a blast.
Everybody will love you there because this is awesome, guys. You guys gotta check this out. Is there anything else I should talk about? I'm just asking you.
Why are you in Detroit?
Detroit's the best.
Why are you in Detroit?
You gotta look at Detroit and see opportunity.
You look at it as one big opportunity.
It's
blank canvas.
I know. When
dirty.
I hear people talk garbage about Detroit, I'm like, fool. Like, no, you don't know what you're talking about. No, because first of all, if you open a business in Detroit and it's unique, and I think my marketing strategy was word of mouth. I'm a big fan of it, not just because it's free, but I just think it's they did it a long time ago and it worked, and you could get people to do things.
We believe the same thing at the
right.
So we should use a microphone for the mouth.
What's that?
We should use a microphone for our mouth. But yeah.
Yeah. There you go. But you know, Detroit. I know there's a lot of places that are all about just promoting new things in Detroit, and that alone, I've had so much press, mostly because I'm in Detroit. Channel 4 here. I've had Ambassador Magazine, Opportunity Detroit, Michigan Radio, a couple blogs, Challenge Detroit.
I think what would be cool, and I'm going to call out IT and the D, what would be really cool I'd like to see is we have a lot of startups here, little IT startups.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And IT and the D knows a lot of them, and it would be cool to see Startup Wars. Where each, because the startup boards are like five, there's usually five people in a startup company.
Yeah. I'm all about like big businesses or like big groups that are in smaller teams and stuff.
Yeah.
And it's fun to just get like those people out here and like there's, you know, people already come in their teams ready and stuff.
You should start
tournaments
startup
and leagues
wars.
Will be the next thing for me. And I think if it's a big enough company where people want to do it, be like, you can have your own league or we can combine leagues or.
There's a bunch of startups here. That are like five-person startups.
Okay.
Yeah. And these, they're all 20 and 30-year-olds. They love this stuff.
Perfect. Yeah.
And it would be cool, and we'll see if we can pull IT&D and give them this clip here, if they can get the startups to do startup wars. Because they're all in an incubator together.
Yeah.
They're all usually in the same building, working in the same area, sharing the same cafeteria or whatever.
Break room.
But it's a great way to sort of cross the line between their companies that they're trying to start
totally.
Over. So it would be cool to have them here and startup wars.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
I would love to cover that. So IT and the D, if you want to, because they're announcers, IT and the D is. So if you want to announce it, we'll film it. We'll do a crossover and do startup wars. That's just an idea here from the
Combined.
Rack.
Combined.
Yeah. Calling you out.
I like it.
Anyways, thank you for having us.
Thanks for coming. Yeah.
This
always,
has been
always
awesome.
A blast just having people here.
No, this was really cool. We're going to go and what are we doing next? Are we doing one more game?
Yeah, well, we've rested enough. We sat down. We're not huffing and puffing at all.
I mean,
we can play more.
Should we do one more game?
Yeah!
Tomar's already got his gun cocked. He's
take
so
us out.
Right
take
now.
Us out. Take us out.
Well, first, I want to ask you about the t-shirts that are available.
Oh, absolutely.
Can they buy them
sorry.
On our website?
You well? Know, I'm going to make that an option. Or you can just email me and be like, I like that shirt, and I'll just send you an
this
invoice
is the
and mail it
he is
out.
Wearing.
I like that one a lot.
It's an awesome shirt.
Yep.
Not messing up your fold job.
It's all good.
And you got the crest.
Retail, baby.
Yeah.
Quick folds.
I used to work at Air Apostles.
I can't do what you guys do.
And these
I can't
are
do it.
That's just how
you
I start.
You and Conrad can
this is how I start off at retail. I can't do it. But now I can.
Yeah, these are $20 a pop, right?
Just fold a billion shirts and you'll be good.
I watch Conrad fold. I'm just like, I cannot do that. They're just my drawers are just shoved with wrinkled shirts.
And these are $20, you said, yes?
$20. Online, they'll probably be like $25 and free shipping or something like that.
Cool.
Here, they're $20.
Very
awesome.
Cool.
Because we want to make sure that your merch gets out there, too, because this is really, really cool.
No, this is absolutely cool. I'm excited for leagues.
You're one of the only people in the Midwest right now doing this.
Yeah.
They might be cropping up, but you're one of the first.
Because,
I mean, you obviously
think
probably
so.
Do research.
Yeah. The way I'm doing it, I think I'm... Definitely.
No, this would be cool to do league play. Absolutely. During the weekdays.
Oh, yeah.
Like
yeah, basically you'd have like a Tuesday league, Wednesday league, Thursday league.
No, this would be really cool.
Yeah.
We could have a Vox league or a Vox team in a league. What do you think?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Thunderdome.
I just say Rachel's on our league. We're gonna,
yeah, she's ridiculous.
Yeah, Rachel, you're on our league. Jomar, I guess, because we don't know why you're so good.
Yeah.
We don't know why you're good. You're just like...
He was like,
Oriental aura, this force field around him.
What?
I don't know. No, I said words.
I know you said words. I just don't think you thought about them before you said them.
I think what it is because these are probably made in China, right? No?
I have no idea, dude.
I'm not sure.
The darts? The darts have to be.
Hasbro.
The darts?
No, Hasbro makes, does it all.
That's China, isn't it?
Yeah.
I love Hasbro. That's also... I'm going to say this. No, that's not.
Okay.
I'm going to say Power Rangers, but they're not Hasbro, are they?
Nah.
That's board games.
Yeah.
Anyway, take us out.
Anyway.
I'm ready. I'm a little tired. I'm hungry. I want to shoot more people.
I want pizza.
I want pizza, too.
But at the Detroit Dart Club, thank you, Connor, for sitting down with us, letting us play. We're going to be doing other stuff. But thank you so much. I'm Conrad for Lucas. We have all of our staff looking at us with their guns.
The
I think
idea.
They realized what we were going to do. So I'm going to go out on this. Thank you so much for listening or on watching Season 3, Episode 13 of The Rack Show, which you can listen to and watch on VoxVii's YouTube channel, VoxVii.com, TheRackShow.com. Also, follow us on Instagram and Twitter, The Rack Show, sorry, all one word. I'm a little nervous because everyone's putting guns at me. Ah! I'm settling into Port Huron. My cat peed on my brand new bed.
Really?
Yep.
I owned it for
16 hours. What I need to do is I need to show her who's boss, and I need to take a gigantic dump in her litter and be like, this is how it's done, all right? Don't mess with me. All right, well, I think that's a great segue into our guest.
Thank you.
No problem. I just figured,
you Madeline, were here last
year. Yeah, Madeline Carlson, you hung out with us last year for our Next Generation episode.
Yeah.
You had a busy year since the last time you were on the show?
Oh, yeah. It was totally busy.
Tell us a little bit about yourself. Like, you're a big deal. Tell us why you're a big deal.
Oh, I'm an actress.
Yep.
That's the whole thing.
She's really great at this. If she doesn't have a script, she doesn't know what to say.